First one we are seeing here is vertical bar diagram, right? And here we have taken a problem or illustration as different years are given to you and different birth rate for that year is given to you, right? So we are taking, first we have drawing the x-axis, then we are drawing the y-axis, then we are taking years on the x-axis. See, the distance between this is to be maintained, right? So, when we are doing this, all this bar diagrams, we will be doing on the graph sheet, right? So, the first centimeter we will leave and the second centimeter will be for the first year. And then leaving the third one, the fourth centimeter for the next year. Likewise, we are taking this. This is the vertical bar diagram. So, we have taken like this. Birth rate, we are taking on the y-axis. And year on the x-axis. Then to the 1951 to 60, it is 45. So, we are taking the value 45. So, you will have to decide about how much you are going to give the units. The unit should be mentioned. One unit equal to 10 numbers or 10 rupees, 10 units that we'll have to. One centimeter equal to 10 units that we have to. So, this is the vertical bar diagram, right? And the second what we are seeing is horizontal bar diagram. See, student's name is given here and the marks we are taking. And we are taking the categories here. The student's category and marks we are taken here. And the horizontal bar diagrams are drawn here. And this is rarely, unless and otherwise it is mentioned in the question, you need not go for horizontal bar diagram. Always we are going for the vertical bar diagrams. So, this is the horizontal one. And next one what we are seeing is multiple bar diagrams. See, the birth rate and the death rate for different years are to be plotted on the diagram. So, first we are taking the year, right? And then we are going to have the birth and the death rate on the y-axis. We are going to take the values. And we are seeing that the minimum value here is 11.5 and the maximum value is 46. So, accordingly, we are taking 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. So, the values are taken. And then what we are doing and we are going for marking the birth rate. So, in the first year. So, here two rectangles to be taken together, right? One is for birth rate and another one is for death rate. Then again, we will be leaving some distance. Then for the next year, birth rate, death rate. And leaving distance, then for the next year, birth rate, death rate together. Now, sometimes it may be three variables also. Like students in science, commerce, arts. So, in that case, instead of two rectangles, we will go for three rectangles. Right? Are you following me? So, this is very easy and you have already done this. This is only to recollect it, okay? So, it is multiple bar diagram. Any number of bars can be taken together. But for 1 year when we are considering, it is to be placed very close here, right? So, this is how we will be making the multiple bar diagrams. And moving on to the next one, it is subdivided bar diagram. So, here there is an illustration giving that the total electricity produced in the economy and produced by hydroelectricity and produced by thermal electricity is given here. So, the year 2013-14 hydro and thermal equal to the total is given. So, first we will have to take the year on the x-axis, then the production on the quantity on the y-axis. Then what we are doing is you go for marking the year and then see the total, right? Either you can do like this, see the total and according to the total, the rectangle will be taken. And in this total, how much is hydroelectricity? It is 46. Starting from the 0 till 46, we will count and this is for hydroelectricity. And the remaining here is for thermal electricity, right? And otherwise, what you can do is 2013-14, 46 is hydroelectricity. So, from 40 till 46, you have taken a line here. And then starting from here, you count 64. And then you will be drawing. So, likewise, this is one diagram for 1 year showing two different variables. And here also it may be for 3 variable, 4 variable, 5 variable, like that.